Hey guys, the third tip I have for you is something that every welder and fabricator has to deal with on a daily basis, and it's not something that's really talked about a whole lot. It's the direction that you weld something. In this case, I'm welding up a frame for a coffee shop, and right now I know everything is perfectly square and true, and if I just go and weld all the same direction, I know when I take everything apart, it will not be true anymore. So you need to use a little bit of strategy and make sure you're welding everything so that when you're finished, everything will still be true. In this case, I would weld from the inside out on my top joint and then the top down. And when I stand the frame up, I would weld both joints opposite of the way I welded the other two. In a situation maybe where I would be welding a piece of tube off the top of this tube, I know that welding this joint here and this joint here would pull this tube up. So what I would do to compensate for that would be I would put a piece of 1/4-inch plate underneath that joint and clamp either side down to the table and preload that tube so that when I'm finished welding and take my clamps off, I know everything will be pretty true. The way metal pulls can be your best friend or your worst enemy, and knowing how to use it makes all the difference. It'll save you a big headache. Trust me, I learned this the hard way. This goes true for MIG welding, TIG welding, stick welding, it doesn't matter. The direction that you weld is the direction that it's going to pull. So if you have something that's out of square a little bit and you need it to be square, then that's the way you want to weld, and it will pull back into tolerance. So I hope that tip helps you guys out.